Hello ladies and gentlemen, Willy here. Given the opportunity, players will optimize the fun out of a game. This is a quote from Soren Johnson, co-designer of Civ 3, lead designer of Civ 4. RTS games are basically its thing. And after having now finished writing this video up and starting to get to recording, I'm not really sure what the point of it is. Maybe it'll make you think about how you or people around you play the game, why people insist on doing things in certain ways, and perhaps why World of Warcraft has changed in the direction that it has over the years. So make of it what you will. Let's start off with some words from Ian Hazzard-Costas. He doesn't need an introduction, I think. Today, people are almost trained to min-max. The community pushes people in that direction, especially socially, even if it's not your preferred playstyle. The people who may want you in your group or may not are holding you to some of those standards. Once it's knowable, you are expected to know. Sid Meier, the grandfather of the Civilization series, once claimed that it's a developer's responsibility to protect the players from themselves. People will gravitate towards what makes them succeed, even if it isn't remotely fun or interesting. If it lets people win, people will do it. So when Sid says developers must protect the players from themselves, and Ian says that people are trained to min-max, what happens if we take those two things and throw them both together? Well, let's take a nice pointing question from Classic in the honor and ranking system and how it was interacted with in 2019 when it first came out. The goal and essence of the honor system is very simple: earn as much honor as possible. That is what ultimately leads to a win, that being your rank. From an RPG point of view, this is all about one player earning as much glory as they can on the battlefield for their faction and being handsomely rewarded. In reality, the most efficient grind is absolutely terrible for players. Long hours, forced pre-made, bracket stacking, phase 2 open world camping, and then inevitable drama around bracket breakers, and this has to go on for months and months before you can reach the high rank. Could PvP just be done solo through battlegrounds? Yeah, sure it could. But this is a system that fails to protect the player from themselves, and the mathematical min-max for honor is just an awful in-game experience. Has anyone even been rank 14 for more than 1 week in WoW's history? Maybe on a super dead realm. How about this, once again from Ian? It's often claimed that players are better at the game than they used to be, but there hasn't really been any change in skill so much as tremendous leaps forwards in our ability to analyze and measure performance. I can find so many sites, videos, spreadsheets and guides on gearing, enchants, consumables and tactics to better my character. My performance in raid is accurately measured against others through details and Warcraft logs. In game, DBM tells me when a boss does something. Azeroth Autopilot tells me where to go to level up. Leatrix Plus sells my trash items to vendors. An item rack changes gear for me. World of Warcraft's hardly the only game out there either that has been solved, so to speak. In fact, some games are made with a real emphasis on difficulty and player learning as one of the key pieces of enjoyment from them, the likes of Dark Souls, Nioh, Bloodborne, or more strategy-based games like StarCraft 2 or Factorio. No matter the game, no matter the genre, a meta will be formed that must be adhered to when concerning a high level of play. And at the most extreme end of a meta, this is where you start getting speedruns, but one prevailing tactic that gives the fastest run is the be-all and end-all of the game now. Entire events like GDQ or ESA have formed around the communities from many games that take part in speedruns too. And in our little corner of the internet in Classic, given that the content is not hard, speedruns have become the main attraction here too. Notice how in retail, nobody really cares who has the fastest clear time from boss 1 to the last boss. It's always been about who can do it first. In Classic, being able to clear it in one day is a given. It's who can do it fastest. And as with any meta, if you want to compete, you have to conform. Remember when Classic first came out and there was the whole race to world first thing? Yeah, 8's a guild pretty much nobody outside of the private server scene knew of just popped up and completely smashed all the competition out of the water. The same could happen for TBC with a totally new guild as well. These are guys who have perfected that meta over and over, server after server. Remember when Joker got world first level 60 and had over 300,000 viewers on Twitch watching him polish off those last few levels through AoE farming? And now today, AoE farming is still more or less the go-to for mages, even without layers. And unlike retail, I think playing to the meta at a reasonably high level is actually a lot more accessible in Classic. We aren't talking about stacking 20 Grand Marshal Warriors with full buffs and Warchief's Blessing here, but having the majority of your raid short with decent gear, correct stats, enchants and world buffs, most consumables, you would have been a literal god in vanilla. Rolling up to a raid after all this preparation and blasting through it in less than 1 hour and saying, "Wow, that was easy," is kind of the expected outcome. It's like going into a test with a sheet telling you all of the answers, and it's as simple as putting the correct answer on the correct line. Of course it's going to be easy. Whilst the guy next to you doesn't have any of these answers at hand, he's going to struggle and learn a lot more. One more quote from Soren Johnson here. The player cannot be trusted to play the game in a fun way, but rather a fashion where they will play better. Some would argue that the feeling of doing well in a difficult video game provides a kind of enjoyment, which is true. However, I'd argue that this is only a feeling many players have when they've been playing the game for a while and they initially struggled with it. The feeling that they are enjoying is a sense of achievement and progression. It's good to know when you're getting better at something you once found challenging. If there was no challenge to start with, it's unlikely that any such feeling would be experienced. It's boring because the game is too easy, and of course some games aren't supposed to be challenging and enjoyment comes from other elements. I'd argue then that the feeling of doing well in a game does not correlate to enjoying the game. You know when you hear about a new game coming out and you go out of your way to avoid spoilers? Yes, they're often story-driven spoilers, but you want to go into it completely fresh and see everything new firsthand. I bet you did the exact opposite with Classic, right? You want to know as much as possible. I know I did. I mean, I did a whole series on each class. How can I say I didn't want to know as much as possible? And I wouldn't have changed it if I didn't do it. I may not be here saying this right now, but it's just interesting stuff to think about, in my opinion. Enough about that. Let's move this random ball of thoughts onward to the social aspects of WoW Classic. Many players attribute the downfall of World of Warcraft to the removal of in-game opportunities to socialize with your fellow players. Yet, after seeing how many people interact with Classic, a game that very much forces you to be more social, I'm not entirely sure that's too true. Retail undoubtedly has less chance to be social, with its various queue systems, fast world travel, with portals, flying, and numerous teleportation items. Whereas in Classic, it can take literally half an hour to get to dungeons sometimes. You must find or create every single group you're part of, and then you have to trade with other players to get items created. Even then, we have a much different player dynamic than we did back in 2004. Back then, your computer was probably only capable of just running WoW by itself. You almost certainly didn't have a second monitor to watch stuff on. You didn't have Netflix, you weren't sitting on Discords with your friends, you weren't talking to people on Battle.net or anything else back then. You were just playing the game, so in some ways, all this downtime made you a bit more curious, a bit more inclined to reach out to the other people in game and have a bit of a conversation with them because they're the people in front of you. It was far more novel talking to strangers online during vanilla, and you were more inclined to add random players to play with again. Also, smaller servers as well, so finding really good players was super rare, and most people didn't even know what a really good player looked like back then. Consider that for a moment. In retail today, most of the content doesn't need you to speak a word to another player. If you aren't doing high level arena mythic plus or mythic raiding, you can easily get by never saying a word. People say this is a bad thing. Honestly though, with the low ending Classic, it requires next to no communication or information to be passed. High end doesn't require any either. In a 40 man raid, people are happy that you can listen and follow. Only really pre-mades could require a mic in PvP. In fact, I think it's harder to have guild-wide social interaction when you need up to 40 players. 20 on retail is a lot more manageable. I personally raided a lot during the 10 man heroic days in Cataclysm, and I like that even more. Bigger isn't necessarily better from a social standpoint. And over time, Blizzard have streamlined the downtime in WoW, finding groups, moving to dungeons or raids, and of course we have across servers to massively boost the player pool in retail as well. That's another thing about Classic, we have servers which are easily 3 to 4 times as large as they were back in vanilla, so there's a bit less emphasis on building relationships with people around you when you just have so many more people to draw from. What about this then? Is finding a heroic Nihilofa pug in retail via LFG so different from somebody spamming a Molten Core weekly pug with a Discord attached? Why level normally and through dungeons when you can just boost through the whole experience? It really feels like players have min-maxed out the social aspects from Classic. Conversations in vanilla would have been, where are you guys from? What talents do you have? Have you guys ever done this dungeon before? And now it's pretty much water please, can we do XYZ quest and you go. People are expected to know everything from the outset. And the more I see this, the more I'm not surprised WoW has taken the route that it has in terms of removing large portions of downtime. We even had a Classic LFG for a brief period pre-launch as well. Imagine that. Finally, let's talk about how players interact with content. I got a really good message from a viewer the other day about how turned off many WoW players are to non-conventional things to do in game. You know, goals that aren't raid, PvP, and grind gold. Stuff like rep grinds, collections, personal challenges, and even twinking is nowhere near as popular as it was in vanilla. And honestly, I'm quite surprised at how very few players are actually going for objectives like this in game. Not many people are doing things like this. If and when we get to Wrath of the Lich King Classic, I bet there will be tons and tons of players going for 100% achievements, because now they will actually have a tangible goal to chase when they are in game. Not to say that a lot of achievement based things haven't been done in Classic. Just over the past few weeks, we've had a 40 man Druid group complete Molten Core and a 40 man Paladin group complete that objective as well. We had a Nixie done the other day where every single player in the raid had no gear. We had the Hardcore Challenge spearheaded by Kargos, which was a thing for a little bit, where the idea was if your character dies anywhere from the journey from 1 to 60, you have to delete and start again, but it never really took off too much. I think an Iron Man challenge has some potential in Classic, that being no trading or grouping, but I think it runs into issues with late game content where progress really comes to a halt because of the limitations, lack of gear progression, and lack of tangible benchmark achievements beyond 60 in profession caps. Old school RuneScape had a player imposed challenge like this, and it became so popular that it was made into an official game mode. Old school RuneScape does fit this format very well though, I'll admit that. Even now, Kungan has returned and is attempting a community-driven challenge. This kind of thing has the best chance to work, where essentially they want to clear all the content whilst only using green quality items, which is kind of a it was sure a better game back then kind of thing. Still, I'm interested to see how far it goes and what they can achieve. I mean, Onyxie was defeated by a zero gear raid, so that gives you some hope at least. So, given the opportunity, players will opt optimize the fun out of a game. I don't think I've ever seen a title where this has held more true than for Classic, not just in optimization towards the content, but the idea that this is the only way to play the game. Not that optimization can't be enjoyable, of course. We can turn off all our add-ons, reset to the default UI, but there are things you can't unwillingly change. Picking a quest reward because you know it's an upgrade over something that looks cool, knowing which zone to go into quest next, understanding where your gold is best spent on leveling abilities and buying items. And despite all this, and this being one of the most optimized games I have ever seen, there are still new discoveries being made by our massive player base. See my video on things that Blizzard had to nerf. And at the end of the day, everyone does enjoy the game differently, but it's hard to get away from a meta or being drawn to the best solution for your problem, and the more you play, the harder this becomes to avoid. At this point, a lot of people are waiting for TBC to fix Classic, and just as many will be waiting for Wrath of the Lich King to fix TBC when we get there. But you can't really ever fix how games are approached now as compared to how they were back then. That's it then, just a few thoughts recently after having read a few bits and pieces online and how they ring true for Classic for me. But like I started off with, there's no sort of big conclusion or realization to be had here, at least for me. So you'll have to let me know what this video made you think about Classic and how it's evolved, if anything. So you can let me know below. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one very soon. If you like what you see, give the video a like and subscribe, as there'll be plenty more to come. Take care, guys, and I'll see you all in the next one.